Hey guys, it is Pamela. Welcome back to my page. I am so excited because I'm 3 weeks post-op and I'm looking snatched. I have to stop looking in the mirror sometimes because when I'm looking in the mirror, I'm like, oh, he's so beautiful now. It's becoming addictive. Anyway, so this video is talking about me returning to work. I did return to work after 2 weeks. Since my surgery on June 18th, I have lost a total of 18 pounds. Most of it was from the surgery, and then most of it was from the eating habit that I have changed since the surgery. My stitches were like very irritated. It was kind of hard for me like wearing the binder at work because like my belly button area was still healing, but it started like kind of like sweating or something. So it was like leaving these like little rings and stuff. I was like, what the heck is that? So I think at week two, I don't feel like I was prepared for work. I feel like I should have taken 3 weeks off, but thank God that my job did work with me to be able to move a little bit slower and to do things a little bit slower. Because normally I'm a very quick person, and if you want to know what kind of job I have, I am a travel agent. I do own a travel business, but I also am, I work in a hospital with a rheumatoid arthritis patients. And so that is something that is high demand. I'm not gonna go into too many details about my job because I don't want people to be like, ooh, let me find her. But with that job, it's a little bit more hard demand. I am moving a lot. It is more tense. When I was going to the surgery, I didn't think it would be as bad returning, but apparently it was. So another issue I had and stuff is like week two is like walking. I could barely like walk, I want to say 20 feet without feeling like I was having an asthma attack. Like I just be like, oh my God, I can't breathe, somebody help. So because it is a hospital and there's a lot of moving around and stuff like that, it was very hard on me walking. So I wanted to talk a little bit about sleeping because this is something I know when I was looking on my YouTube channels, you know, to figure out ways before my surgery about sleeping, not many people talk about it. You hear people talking about postpartum, like the first week or two, how you're sleeping with a couple pillows, but you don't hear many people talking about afterwards. So I am around week three, and so as you can see, this is my bed. I'm here all cozy, and I have a king-size bed. Of course, me and Bob are hanging out as always. And so with it, sometimes I have to adjust the pillows. So I'm gonna kind of do like a little quick demonstration in this video to show you different patterns that you see use to get comfortable. With me having the liposuction, the first, second week, I had to start like sleeping on a chair because my chairs in the living room are just for decorations. Like they are not comfortable at all. But the hardness of the chairs was able to give me the body, the comfort zone I needed to sleep on with the liposuction. So if you had liposuction and you're having pain, you had pain like me, your size or whatever, I do recommend you sleeping on something hard because I'm telling you, that thing made a miracle. So what I did is I like put a pillow up under my side, and then I had like three pillows stacked for my head, and then like I turned on either or side. So I am a side sleeper. I cannot sleep on my back. Like I feel like I wake up snoring in the middle of the night and something went down my throat and I'm like, I cannot do this. So I have found little tricks and ways to help me sleep with my faja on because the faja sometimes is so tight. So when I try to turn over and everything, like I cannot get comfortable to save my life. So I'm gonna do a quick demonstration. Another way that you can kind of get comfortable. So I generally stack like two pillows there, two behind me, and then I'll have this one pillow between my legs, and then that way I can like lay at an angle. Sometimes with the faja it kind of gets really intense. And okay, so this is another way that works for me. So like having my head here and then choosing whatever side, and then having my legs wrap over these pillows kind of help. Or if you're laying like on your back, you can lay flat have it back there posted and then have her legs go over it. That kind of gives me a little bit of comfort as well too. Okay guys, so this is how I kind of like use the sleep. So I stack up, as you see, like three pillows there, and I will do like two where I can lay down. And oftentimes when I'm laying either on the right or the left side, I will stick a pillow between my leg to kind of arch me a little bit. Sometimes
babies in the bassinet and be calm, we get ready.
So with the this week I did have some swelling kind of in like in my butt area. This is like where I guess, well, it's not in my butt, it's like my hips, where the drains were originally. And like I do get a lymphatic massage tomorrow. I'm so excited, I miss her so much. It's been 2 weeks without one, and I'm telling you, I can tell my body when I do not get those massages. The tightness in my stomach, like as you can see here, like it's so tight. And like when she does the massages, I don't feel that tightness in their that release. I did lose 18 pounds. Woohoo! Since my surgery, I'm super excited about it. I was originally in a large faja, but now I am currently in a medium faja. So I'm excited that I finally kind of rotated down. So I'm seeing the symptoms a little bit more. Okay guys, this is me at week 3. I have a little bit of like swelling here going on, and I have like some swelling going on here. So I want to talk a little bit about my symptoms this week. Itch, 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 itch. I swear my whole body just itches, like, ugh. And like I have a scratch. I tried Benadryl, cortisone 10, Benadryl cream, nothing worked. I ended up calling my doctor. My doctor had to call me in a prescription for Zyrica. Apparently, the pain or the itch, well, not the pain, the itching that I'm having is from the nerve damage. So the nerves are trying to repair, and apparently it makes your body itch. I'm like, oh, why did somebody tell me it's just bad? Like, it's just itchy. I'm like, ooh. I have to refrain myself sometimes from scratching in public because people be looking at me like, you know, but it itches so bad. Okay, so another thing that happened this week is my doctor prescribed me Cobalzole, which is a cream that helps with my scar. I just started it a couple days ago. It's supposed to help with like the thinning kind of my scar. As you can see, my scar is pretty thick still. Apparently it takes like 2 weeks and then it'll thin out a little bit and I'll be more snatched. So I'm excited about that. So here is where you can see kind of like where I'm a little swollen. I'm loving my waistline. Like when people see me in the back, they're like, oh my God, your waist is so small. I'm like, right, that's me. So I have developed this fetish to look at myself more. Like I've never looked at my body before like this. Like now I'm just like, man, I feel good. I can wear anything and feel a little bit more comfortable. I am super excited. I have been having so many people reach out to me. So many people have been signing up for surgeries. And I'm like, you know, I guess I'm leading the revolution to all my friends now, because not everybody is like, I want to do surgery. I do highly recommend it. I recommend it for my doctor. If you want to use him, you can hit me up. I'll give you his information. I have my 4-week follow-up with him this upcoming Wednesday. So he will be taking pictures of me. He'll also be posting those pictures of my before and after on his personal business page. So you will be able to see everything on that page. Boobies, nipples, everything. I can't really show like that here on Instagram and on YouTube and Facebook or whatever, whichever one you're watching. Because, of course, they would shut down my YouTube channel and I don't have problems like that. But some of my friends, I have inboxed them like real in-depth pictures of me like, this is me. So I just want to give you guys the update on my symptoms. I want to apologize right now because this video is a little bit late. I had a rough week and there's no excuse, but this is why it's a little bit later than my other videos. I try to get them pushed out around the same day, same time, so you guys can get prepared for your preparation for your surgery. So I look forward to seeing you guys next week at my 4-week video.
I will be going over me wearing clothes. I'm going to be